First of all, thank you so much for signing up for Life Transformed email list. So what I do is I do video emails, and you'll typically get 6 in a week, not on Sunday. And they're usually going to be, you know, anywhere from 4 to 6 minutes or so. So what I found for me, it's easier and I'm more comfortable doing videos than I am writing. And people have said it's more convenient to just kind of listen when you're getting ready or whatever it may be. So this video is specifically part of your welcome package. All right. So I sent you a PDF that you probably have printed off by now. If not, print that off. And this will just be your guide. This video will be your guide on how to use the information in that print off. And these steps, these things I'm going to take you through really transform my life and continue to transform my life. And it's called transforming your day. So you start your day with gratitude. So important. I've researched this, and so many different people, experts, quote unquote experts, successful folks say gratitude, and starting your day in gratitude is so good. So what I like to do, and you'll notice on your sheet, it's got big, small, and experience. So something big, you know, what are you grateful for? Something big, you know, for example, that I was able to move here to North Carolina and enjoy the mountains. I mean, that's a pretty big deal. I'm so grateful for that. Something small, that I have coffee in the morning. It could be just as small as that, or I get to see the leaves on the ground from fall. You know, something small. And then an experience. I really want you to think into, in the last 24 hours, what was an experience that I'm grateful for? Could have been spending some time with a loved one that you don't see all the time. What this does is it gets your mind started in the right way in gratitude. And the more you can carry that gratitude out into your life, the better off you're going to be. Next step is excited. So there I do write down 3 things that I'm excited about. So what am I excited about this particular day? Just 3 things. I'm excited I woke up this morning. That could be it. I'm excited I, you know, got right out of bed and didn't hit the snooze alarm. Or I'm excited because I'm going to have lunch with one of my best friends. Or I'm excited because I've got a big presentation coming today that I'm super excited about, whatever it may be. But again, it's all a part of your mind, your brain, and getting you in the right mindset. So 3 things you're excited about. And then what is going to be your focus for today? What are you going to focus on? Maybe you want to focus on eating healthy. Right, so you just want to make that a focus for the day. Whatever that focus is, that thing that you want to reinforce, and you can spend some time. I left enough room there, right? You can write in, you know, how you're going to maintain that focus during the day. Really good. And then the next one is going to be affirmation. What is your affirmation? And for me, the affirmation tends to be something that's a continuum. It's a continual thing, like I want to embody love and wisdom each and every day. That's my affirmation. I'm going to embody love and wisdom each and every day. Right? So that just grounds me in, you know, who I am. What is my intention? What is my affirmation? Next is exercise. So again, I've gone from that crazy exercise person who would spend way too many hours in the gym every single day to about 3 sessions of weight training and then 3 sessions of some kind of walking or hiking. Here in Carolina in the mountains, we can hike a lot. So I do a lot of hiking. But I don't do the high intensity cardio anymore. I've found that you don't really need to. But that's a whole nother topic. So there's just a spot there for exercise. And next is jam. And I've got 3 spots there, 3 lines on your printout for jam. And a jam is really, I learned this from Darren Hardy. He said any human, the best humans on the planet only have about 4.5 hours of good work in them a day. That's it. And the most any human can focus on one thing is 90 minutes. So this is your chance to plug in 3 90-minute jams. Of course, depending on your lifestyle, the kind of work you do, you know, I've worked in the jobs where you're there 8-10 hours, but I think it can still work. right? So if you can plan, if you know that that's the best you got in you, and you can plan these jams to the extent that you can in your life, do it. Plan the jams. And the best part about that, and we'll get to this at the end, is if you can get that first jam in your day, the one, and that should be the thing that is most important for you to get done that day. So what I do, for example, is I set my alarm early before anybody else. Most people get up about 4:55, and I start my jam, whatever the most important thing is of the day. 90 minutes, I set my timer on my phone, and I just do it. I get everything laid out, and I'll talk about that here in a little bit. But then what happens is you've got that done, right? The most important thing of the day is done before your day has really even started. Because what Darren talked about was once 8 a.m. hits, all bets are off. Your day can just cascade out of control. All right, so that's kind of powerful. It's been a powerful tool for me. And next line is recharge. And I listed three areas there, recharge. So in between these jams, again, from Darren, he talks about that we need a recharge. So think of it as a cell phone. We only have so much charge. Think of those 4.5 hours as that's our battery life in a day, what we can do. But we need recharge time. So in between those jams, you need to plug in recharge time. It could be a nap. I love taking an afternoon nap. It could be a walk, just a nice leisurely walk. It could be listening to some music. It could be reading, if that is a recharge activity for you. Anything that you do that renews your energy. Could be sketching or drawing or whatever. Singing, playing an instrument, whatever it may be. So come up with some recharge activities that you can plug in between your jam time. Okay? Next we have big wins. So now we're coasting to the end of your day. So at the end of your day, what you want to do is you want to write down your three big wins for the day. And again, they don't have to be huge, huge things. My earlier example, I want to eat healthy today. So maybe you've eaten healthy all day. You can say a big win was I maintained my focus. I ate healthy all day. Or I reached out to an old friend that I hadn't spoken to in years and we had a tremendous conversation. Again, that's all about getting the mindset and training your brain, right? These are all positive things to feed your brain and change your habits and your mindset. So the three big wins. And then how will I improve? So you just got through thinking about, all right, these are my big wins. Now based on those wins, think about, why did I achieve those wins? What was it about those things, those experiences that made them wins? And now how am I going to improve? How am I going to carry whatever learning I got today into tomorrow? And then the final part is the sprint prep. I love the sprint prep. That is where you sit down at the end of your day. And it's important to each day to say, closed. At this time, I'm done. Whatever time that is, done. And if you need some downtime, whatever, right? But I'm closed for business. You have to have a closed time every day. And the sprint prep is you just sit down and figure out what is the most important thing for me to get done first thing tomorrow morning. And what I do, I've got an office out here, and I lay everything out on the office. I've got the paper ready, whatever the topic is. I've got my candle, everything set. So when an alarm goes off, I can come right over here and do the most important thing. So that's the sprint prep. You're prepping for the next day, so you're off to that good start again. So you guys, I guarantee you, if you implement these things, you are going to transform your day. There's some other components to my day that I'll be sharing with you as you go. Again, welcome to Life Transformed. We are going to add value to you with these emails. Every once in a while, we'll give you an offer, a way that you can engage with us on a deeper level. But mostly it's going to be adding value to you. And our goal is to create that relationship of trust with you so you all know what we're all about. We're about a community of people who are for you, don't judge you, and in harmony with you. And we're helping to get people out of isolation and into community. And that's what we do. All right, thanks again, you guys.